Hello, thank you for coming by our poster about RAPT, the Read Assembly and Annotation Pipeline Tool, building a prokaryotic genome annotation package for users of all backgrounds. My name is Françoise Thibault-Nissen. I'm not at this meeting, but my colleague Deacon Sweeney is there and available to answer any questions. What is RAPT? RAPT is a one-step tool for the assembly and annotation of bacterial and archaeal isolates, starting from Illumina reads. It brings together SCISA and PGAP. So consider this very common workflow where a scientist will collect some samples, bring them back to the lab, gross them, isolate the DNA from each sample, sequence the DNA, assemble the reads, annotate the genomes that is produced, and then moves on to the analysis of the gene content. RAPT takes care of the middle steps. It will assemble the genome with SCISA, and it will annotate it with PGAP. SCISA assembles Illumina reads in parallel. It is based on the De Bruijn graph, it's fast, it's repeatable, and it handles low levels of contamination well. You can learn more about SCISA on our GitHub site. PGAP is a very mature pipeline that annotates coding and non-coding genes and pseudogenes. It has been used for the annotation of the more than 220,000 RefSeq assemblies currently available. It is available on GitHub as a standalone package that you can run on your own. The inputs to RAPT are short reads from Illumina machine, high accuracy genomic reads from a single isolate. Sorry, no metagenomic data at the moment. RAPT will produce an annotated assembly in a variety of format. It will also verify the organism name that was provided with the reads on input. So, how to use RAPT? Well, the easiest way is to use the RAPT web service that is hosted at NCBI. It requires no command line skills and just a minute to set up a job. Here's how it works. You log into our website. Once you've logged in, you have the option of providing an SRA run, SRR, ERR, or DRR run from the sequence read archive, or you can upload a FASTQ file directly out of your Illumina sequencer. It can either be a single file, or it can be two files if the forward and the reverse reads are in two different files. Then you just press submit and you wait. Shortly after you have submitted the job, you will receive a notification that the job has started. You can also follow the status of the job that you started on our website. You can have your very own list. After a couple hours, you will receive a link to the results and a download button that will allow you to download a package containing the assembled genome in FASTA format and the annotation in GenBank, FASTA, and GFF format. It will also include the results of the taxonomy verification using the average nucleotide identity tool. As an alternative, you can run RAPT yourself on your own machine. You download the command line interface from our GitHub site, and then just provide the genomic reads to that Python application. Either the FASTQ file and the organism name that is associated with the FASTQ, or just provide the SRA accession and run. A couple hours later, you will get the annotated genome. In order to run RAPT on your own machine, you need to have at least 100 gig of free storage space on disk. You need to have internet connection, and the machine that you use needs to have at least 8 CPU and 32 gig of memory. We recommend 4 gig of memory per CPU. You need to have Python, and you need to be able to run Docker, Podman, or Singularity. Finally, we have a special implementation of RAPT for users of the Google Cloud platform. So check out our GitHub wiki page for more details on that. And finally, send us your feedback. We're always happy to hear about your experience. Thank you very much for coming by and enjoy the rest of the meeting.